Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lian Duan, and I have developed for over 20 years, specializing in DevOps and cloud security. In today's video, we are going to explore AWS EKS architecture and compare it to setting up Kubernetes on AWS Bare Metal. To summarize, AWS EKS takes care of critical elements such as the control plane, ensuring it is high availability, by automatically managing components like etcd instances and other Kubernetes control plane components. Let's move to compare detail. Setting up Kubernetes on AWS Bare Metal. Imagine setting up Kubernetes on AWS as constructor supermarket. Here, you follow the technical steps to ensure everything runs smoothly. Initially, you provision servers, like setting up the foundation elements of a supermarket. Ensure these servers communicate is similar to the communication different area in supermarket. Subsequently, you install specialized operation system as Linux distribution, such as setting up the supermarket operation system. Next, you integrate a container runtime, similar to implementing a store-wide management system. Using the tools such as kubeadm, you configure the team of helper to orchestrate seamless operations, like assembling a team to organize supermarket activities. This team consists of masternodes, which are like the brains of the operation, and the worker nodes, which are like the hands doing the work. Once completed, you have full control over the supermarket. To keep Kubernetes high availability, the master nodes and etcds are in the three availability zones, like the diagram. By the way, the etcd is used to store all Kubernetes configuration information. Also, the work nodes need to deploy three AZs, such as US East 2A, US East 2B, and US East 2C. Now, let's move to how to approach with the AWS EKS. What is AWS EKS? AWS EKS is managed Kubernetes service by Amazon Web Services. Consider AWS EKS as a medical service that automates the management of a supermarket's operations without diving into detail level. It simplifies the process of deploying, managing, and scaling containerized applications. The master node calls EKS control plane in AWS EKS. AWS EKS ensures the availability of control plane, similar to managing an accessible managerial office. The control plane includes specialized components like medical helpers, etcd instance, and the critical leaders, Kubernetes API service. AWS dynamically scales those components, similar to deploying additional staff when the supermarket on holiday season. Automatic secure patches ensure the secure and up-to-date environment, like quick fixing any issues in the supermarket's operations. To achieve above goals, AWS runs the following in the control plane. A minimum of three etcd instances are in the two availability zones. Minimum of two instances of the rest of the Kubernetes components in two availability zones. A minimum of two other control plane components in two availability zones. By the way, EKS will deploy to AWS Full Control Virtual Private Cloud. It isolated with our VPC. How to create an EKS cluster with the master and worker nodes. There are two steps. First step, provision master node. It lacks main branch overseeing everything in the supermarket. Second step, you decided whether to deploy real entities as EC2 instances or virtual entities as Fargate for worker nodes. One consideration is storage for etcd is limited. Etcd storage is limited to 8 GB as per upstream guideline. You can monitor the etcd DB total size in bytes metrics for current etcd usage size. That's all for today's topics. By the end of this video, you'll understand how AWS EKS simplifies the Kubernetes deployment process. Thank you for watching and see you in the next time.